Welcome to this week's episode of Brainstorm, where we give you a glimpse into the world of science. For Thursday, March 26, 2014, I'm James Gurney, filling in for Jack this week. We begin with an update from the world of material science, as it applies to biology. Now, normally we don't cover graphene or carbon nanotube-related stories, but this week we'll make an exception. Scientists from MIT have been experimenting with carbon nanotubes and photosynthesis, with some interesting results. This all started when they wanted to create self-repairing solar cells inspired by the chloroplasts in plant cells. As part of this work, they began to study isolated chloroplasts, but there was a problem. These organelles contained all the necessary components to perform photosynthesis, but without the rest of the cell, they began to degrade quickly due to a buildup of oxygen-based free radicals. To counteract this, they added nanoparticles of cerium oxide because they're powerful antioxidants. To further enhance the function of these isolated chloroplasts, they tried adding carbon nanotubes. We won't go into all the details involved in photosynthesis, but essentially the first stage involves a flow of energetic electrons caused by light hitting chlorophyll molecules. Natural photosynthesis only uses about 10% of incoming light, and carbon nanotubes react similar to chlorophyll for a wide spectrum of photons. Adding both nanomaterials to the chloroplasts increased electron flow within them by around 50% and made them last hours longer. They then infused living plants with carbon nanotubes, which increased the electron flow by 30%. But it's still unclear whether that translates to an actual increase in sugar production. More research is necessary, but the scientists are excited by the possibilities of plant-based nanotechnology, including using already designed carbon nanotubes that can react to certain chemicals in the environment by changing how they fluoresce under UV light. Plants like this can be used to passively detect explosives and other chemical agents without the need for electrical power. Actually, only one story this week, but there's a good reason. Q Dragon will be doing an hour-long science news discussion live this Saturday for the Madness, Mayhem and Charity event. It's to raise money for the International AIDS Vaccine Initiative, an amazing cause that helps support vital scientific research. Check the video description for more information, including where the event will be, the Indiegogo with perks for donation, and the schedule for the entire 36-hour event. Hope you enjoyed this episode. No question this week, just make sure you check out those links.